Dear students of CBSE Class 10, today we'll discuss Chapter 2, Sectors of the Indian Economy, from Economics section. Listen to the discussion attentively till the end and try to solve the questions given at the end of the lecture. I am sure that it will help you to score high marks in the examination. This whole chapter has been divided into 5 topics. The gist of the chapter brought into 5 topics. Let's start step by step. Now, first of all, sector of economic activities. Now, different sectors of economic activities, people are engaged in various economic activities producing goods and services. These economic activities can be grouped into 3 categories: primary, secondary, and tertiary sectors. Primary sector covers activities that are undertaken by directly using natural resources. For instance, agriculture, dairy, fishing, forestry, etc. are called primary sector. Secondary sector covers activities in which natural products are changed into other forms through the ways of manufacturing that we associated with industrial activities. It is also called industrial sector. Next comes tertiary sector. Tertiary sector covers activities that help in the development of primary and secondary sectors. These activities do not produce goods, but they are an aid or support for the production process. Trade, transport, banking, etc. are example of it. It is also called the service sector. Now, these are the different activities. On the basis of activities, we group these activities into 3 sectors. Next is comparing the 3 sectors. We are going to compare among the 3 sectors. Let's see the comparison. Number 1, first of all, the primary sector was the most important sector of economic activities at initial stage of the development of our country. When the country started development fast, we gave more importance on our agriculture. With the introducing of the new machineries, new methods and the manufacturing system, the industrial sector, the secondary sector, gradually become important in the total production and employment, in the field of employment. Now, in the past 100 years, there has been a further shift from secondary to tertiary sector in developed countries. Gross domestic product, GDP, is the sum of final goods and services produced in the 3 sectors of a country during a particular year. So, this is the comparison of primary, secondary and tertiary on the basis of the value. Now, next is primary, secondary and tertiary sector in India. Point number 3, that is topic number 3. Third topic, and the first subtopic is primary sector. Let us see in India, what is the scenario of primary sector? So, primary sector in India, the primary sector continues to employ the largest number of people in India from 1973 to 2000, because not enough jobs were created in the secondary and tertiary sectors. More than half of the workers in the country were working in the primary sector, mainly in agriculture, producing only a quarter of GDP. In contrast to this, secondary and tertiary sectors are producing 3/4 of the producers, whereas they employ less than half the people employed in the agricultural sector or the primary sector. One main reason for that was more people were in agriculture, they engaged than its requirement. So the excess number of people engaged in the agriculture were not adding any output in the production process. It is called the disguised unemployment or underemployed. Now see, next condition in India, that is a secondary sector. Primary sector, we saw that there is a, before it was very much important, day by day secondary sector is increasing because disguised unemployment, I say. Now secondary sector, in order to create more employment, government invests some money to promote and locate industries in semi-rural areas where a large number of people may be employed. After that, gradually public and private industries grew up, mainly agro-based industries in India. gave more importance because it is an agricultural country. Next comes to the third subtopic, tertiary sector in India. What is the scenario of tertiary sector or the service sector in India? Let's see. The tertiary or the service sector in India employs different kinds of people. A study conducted by the Planning Commission estimates that nearly 20 lakhs jobs can be created in the education sector alone. Some study and the same study by the Planning Commission says that if tourism as a sector in as a sector it improved, every year we can provide additional employment to more than 35 lakhs people. At the same time, in India, many doctors, nurses, health workers, etc. need it. So our tertiary sector is becoming more important day by day. In 2005, National Rural Employment Guarantee Act passed for 100 days guaranteed job for the rural people. Now, this is the scenario of the primary, secondary and tertiary sector. Now, number four topic is division of sector as organized and unorganized. On the basis of organized and unorganized, what are the differences? Now see that the sectors are divisions. How to divide the sectors? Number one, organized sectors cover those enterprises or places of work where the term of employment are regular and people have assured work. These enterprises are registered by the government and have to follow its rules and regulations, like Factories Act, like Minimum Wages Act, etc. Workers get several benefits from the employers, like paid leave, like payment during holidays, like provident fund, like pensions, gratuity, medical benefits, etc. That is called the organized sector. In case of unorganized, on the other hand, unorganized sector is characterized by small and scattered industries, units of the industries, which are largely outside the control of the government. The workers are low paid. There is no provision for overtime, paid for leave, no holidays properly, leave due to the sickness, etc. These facilities are deprived of that particular workers of that unorganized sector. So this is the difference between the organized and unorganized sector in our country. Now next is the topic sectors, number five, sectors in terms of ownership, public and private sectors. Let's see. Now, in the public sector, the government owns most of the assets and provides all the services. For example, Indian Railways. These industries aim for social welfare and give all kind of facilities to the workers. In the private sector, ownership of assets and delivery of services in the hands of the private individuals or companies like Tata Iron and Steel Company Limited. These enterprises are mainly for the purpose of making profit. So students, regarding these sectors of the Indian economy, within these five particular topic, the gist of the chapter already been discussed thoroughly. Now I am going to give the important questions from this chapter, what may come with probable questions. Listen to me. Now, first is, what is meant by gross domestic product, GDP? How is GDP measured in India? Number one, very important question. Number two, describe the importance of primary sector in the Indian economy. Now, number three, explain reasons for the rising importance of the tertiary sector in India. Number four, how can employment be increased in both rural and urban areas? Number four question is over. Number five, explain the objectives of National Rural Employment Guarantee Act 2005. Number six, how can workers in the unorganized sectors be protected? Explain. So these are the questions. After listening all this explanation properly, this topic, you will be able to write down the answer. I am sure you'll get high marks if you try to write yourself and you'll be self-dependent. Thanks a lot to watch till the end. Write all your doubts in the comment box. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanking you all.